Our application will be open starting today. So you can go and apply if you've had it in your head and you know what you want. Awesome. Log right in. Start applying. It will be due on Monday, June 15th. It will close. There won't be any exceptions. So you have between now and Monday, June 15th to get that application in and tell all your friends and help them out. Hold them accountable to get it in. You will be notified by July 1st, that's a Wednesday, July 1st, if you have been accepted into Immerse this year. And if you haven't, you will also receive some communication from me as well. So all communication will go out to all artists who have applied by July 1st. Our event dates, recap again, 3 days, October 16th, 17th, and 18th, with the 18th only being from noon until 3, 16th and 17th, 5 to 11 p.m. All questions regarding stages, programming, everything you can think of, if you're an artist, direct them to me, crystal@creativecityproject.com. If you direct them to anyone else, that's just going to come to me anyway. So just direct them right to me and you'll get the fastest answer that I can possibly give you. So shall we dive into our application and go through that? I think we're going to pull up our application and kind of look at what you would see if you were to log in and start to apply. So, of course, you will get your name. We need that, your name. And if you have an organization, make sure you list that. That's really helpful for us as well. Fill in all of the normal information, your address. It's great for us to know where you're from. And your phone number, definitely need that, really important. Let us know if you've attended as an audience member and if you've been a past Immerse artist. It's really helpful to know that as well, just to know your exposure with Immerse. And it's perfectly fine and great if you have had neither of those. That's fine. I just like to know, and the team likes to know when we're looking at your application. Title of the work you'd like to present at Immerse 2020. Don't worry. I know you guys ask me this every single year. Yes, it can change. Yes, it can change. But put something down that you're thinking of, that you're mulling over, that we can use to look at. Check everything that applies to your art, music, installation art, circus. Is there some magic? Is there drawing? Anything. Check it all. If it's other, please tell me what that other is so I don't have to guess. Let's see. Please agree that you're available on the days that we need you to be available. We will work out a specific time for you to perform on stage if you're a performance artist, but we just need you to be available and just agree to that right there. Next, let us know if you're available for Sunday. Like I said, not everybody has to be available for Sunday, but if you are, let us know so we can program you for that. The most important part, tell us what you want to do. Describe your performance or your installation. Put it all down. The more information, honestly, the better, in the most concise way you can give it. So don't write me 6 paragraphs if you can say it in 1, but give me as much information as you know about what you want to do. That will help our programming team as we kind of dive into the applications and really sift through what we can make happen and make possible. Estimated time of your performance. If you're performing a dance or you have a music work, let us know how long it is. 15-minute max on stage. No maximums on the street. If you're doing a street performance, we'll work that out with you and figure that out. And installations, if there's a time component within your installation, it loops every 15 minutes. Great to know. Put that in there as well. Please submit a sketch, an image, a video, anything that will help us know you better as an artist. It is okay if it has nothing to do with what you are going to do this year, because hopefully it's new. Maybe you haven't created it. But what it does do is give us a sense of who you are when we're just looking at a screen and words. And we're artists, so we like to see things. So show us who you are in some way that makes sense for you. Let's see. Choose the type of space that would best fit you. Do you want to perform on a stage? Do you want to be on the street, in a sidewalk, in a tent? Is it something different that we haven't listed? Let us know. Describe your intended audience experience. So this is important for us to know kind of what you're thinking. Do you want this to be something interactive that could change maybe where we put you? Do you want this to be quiet? Your audience needs to have headphones on and they need to hear it. What is their experience going to be like? What do you intend for their experience to be like? Put that in there so we can place you and put you in the right spot. The next one is about tech stuff. So we, of course, on stage have lights and sound and power. So don't worry about any of that. If there's something special extra that you need, Talk about it right in there. For all of our installation artists, we have power at Communal Generators, so also don't worry about that, but just let me know what you need. If you think you're going to need a massive amount of power for something, that's a good place to put it in. If it's just you're plugging in a couple things, that's totally fine. Then let us know any technical elements you plan to bring. So if you are bringing a chair on stage in your performance, let us know. I've got a big chair that's going to sit 6 people on it, or I've got 7 stools that are going to be on stage with me. Just let us know what you're bringing for the installation as well. I'm building a house that I'm going to put in the middle of the street. Let us know what you're bringing so we know what you are providing as well. And then check a stipend option. At Creative City Project, we really value paying our artists. We wish we could put another 0 at the end of every offer that we make. Hopefully one day we'll be able to, but let us know what you're asking for to participate in Immerse. And there is some options. And if you do request other, please let us know what that other is as well. And that's the whole application. Pretty straightforward. Sign it, date it. If you want to help, you can put down that and you'll go to our volunteer database. And it just tells you again, you'll be notified by July 1st. So if you have any questions on the application as you're filling it out, please, please, please feel free. Shoot me a quick email. I will respond as quickly as possible. I want you to make sure that you're comfortable filling it out so we get all the best information and we can really support you when you're presenting your work.